If I'm going to use the physical inventory counting per period functionality, I need to define first on my item card or my stock keeping unit card a counting period code that determines the next counting interval. So this, for example, is on one item here. And I can now go into my journal to calculate it. And it's the physical inventory journal I need to go into. This one to do the counting. In here I have two different strategies. The calculate inventory strategy is typically for normal annual countings, and what we're doing here is the calculate counting period strategy. So I like to calculate per period, and automatically it displays the items available for this type of counting, and I can select them in here, one or more items, the item that I'm going to count right now, and I can see here the counting period. Be aware that this is sensitive to the working date in the system, so now when I do the counting and it updates in the system, they won't appear again after December this year. So I'll just press OK. It provides automatically a document number, and I could have changed the posting date or left it here like I want to. And this is actually now ready to count. The calculated quantity displays, the calculated physical quantity that I can enter here, and like when I do normal annual countings, I could print this one, preview, and I could have printed it with serial and lot numbers and with expected quantities or without expected quantities. And this is now a signal for my warehouse people to go and do this counting. And maybe here's a difference. We only had 84, and this one we had 87, and in 84 here and 87, and it would automatically enter the quantities and negative and positive adjustment like when I do normal annual countings. Now when I post it like this, it will automatically update my next counting period. So first of all, if I try to calculate it again in here, I can see nothing in this isn't here, and it will only pop up again within the next period after December this year, those two items. And if I look at my stock keeping unit card, I can see here the next counting period start date is updated for both this item and the other item if I look at the stock keeping unit card.